Good afternoon. Welcome to our third classical Quincy Symphony Orchestra concert of our season 2021-2022. And I want to welcome and wish all the moms in the audience a very happy Mother's Day. On behalf of the orchestra, also want to thank our own moms who put up with us over the years as we practiced incessantly over the years to get to where we are in front of you today. Speaking of today, we have a special guest artist, the winner of our 2020 Youth Performance Competition. Each year, we typically have the concert performance in May, as it is this month. However, with COVID, we didn't have performances in 2021 or 2020. So here in 2022, we're welcoming our winner of the 2020 Eleanor B. Nelson Concerto Competition, Andrew Gu. And I think you'll be very, very pleased with the performance of Rachmaninoff's second piano concerto. The scholarship winner also is named after Robert E. Brown, who was conductor of the Quincy Symphony Orchestra for a number of years. And so in addition to winning the Eleanor B. Nelson Concerto Competition, Andrew will be the recipient of a scholarship today. So we're looking forward to performing with Andrew. To finish off our concert today will be a very recognizable symphony, Symphony No. 9 by Antonin Dvorak. Many of you may have heard of the New World Symphony, and that's the number 9. Many themes that will be very familiar to you from performances in the past, or even if you're filmgoers and you listen to the opening theme to Jaws, listen from the beginning of the fourth movement for that particular motive. So I welcome you all. Again, happy Mother's Day to all the moms in the audience, and enjoy the program.
Good afternoon, everyone. Happy Mother's Day. You are in for a treat today. We have an amazing young pianist, and we will lift the lid. Let me do that real quickly. The gentleman who came up here earlier is a virtuoso pianist, world-renowned, and he's Andrew's teacher, and I'm sure he was shocked to see this thing down, but we're gonna race. So without further ado, we're gonna play Rachmaninoff's second piano concerto with our soloist, Andrew Goo. Please give him a big hand.
Thank you. Thank you.
I'd like to call Andrew back to the stage for a quick moment after a wonderful performance. Andrew, if you would, join me here. First of all, I understand your parents are with us, is that true?
Yeah, both my parents, my mom and my dad, are in the audience. would Andrew's mom and dad, Helen Goodman, would you stand? Congratulations. And congratulations to you. What a wonderful performance. As promised, you're the recipient of the Robert E. Brown Scholarship, and on behalf of the Board of Trustees of the Quincy Symphony Orchestra and the Quincy Symphony Orchestra ourselves, I'd like to present you with this scholarship check. Thank you so much, and congratulations again. One more time for Andrew.
What did you guys think of that, Andrew? Isn't he something else? We're going to finish the concert with Dvorak's New World Symphony, written in 1893, right here in the United States. Dvorak was visiting here, teaching at a conservatory. He was a director of a conservatory in New York City for a couple of years. And actually, he wrote this symphony in New York City as well as Spillville, Iowa. And it's probably one of the most popular symphonies ever written, and we just want to show you a little thing in it, because one of the things that Dvorak did in this symphony is that he took a couple of themes in the first movement and he kind of put them in each movement. Some of them a little more obvious, some of them a little more hidden. And since we don't have a lot of time, we're just going to show you one of them, okay? And so this is the closing theme of the exposition. I want you to remember that, okay? here's what it sounds like, all right? And then we're going to show you where in each of the movements he puts it. All right, here's the theme. Listen for it in the flute. Now I'm going to ask Ro to play the first four bars of it for us again, and I want you to listen very carefully because I'm going to get you to sing it too, okay? All right, here we go. Can we sing that together? One, two, ready, go. Dun, 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 dun. One more time. One, two. Dun, 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 dun. Now, he has it. Now we're going to play a section from the second movement, and he's got it hidden. We're going to play the first. Let us play for you, just two bars, and see if you can hear it in there, okay? Could you kind of hear it? I'm just going to get the violins, horns, and woodwinds to play, okay? One more time, just by themselves so you can hear that tune. Dun, 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 dun. All right, now here's a section from the third movement, all right? Listen for it in the trumpet. It's played in the trumpet, you'll be able to hear it. Did you hear it? Okay, now. There's just a small snippet of it in the last movement. It comes just towards the end, and it's played by the horn. I'm going to have the horn play it for you. Listen for that at the end. All right. This is Dvorak's New World Symphony. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you.